define each of these components, we will define listening, language, and speech. We look at these sub areas of components under each of them. We will explore what are the breakdowns that we see in the classroom in each of these areas. And then some strategies that I can implement in my classroom to create a UDL class for speaking and listening.
Executive function is like this control center in your brain. Alright? You have all of these various skills, but executive function tells you what to use and when. So the air traffic control is that analogy for us to keep in our heads. That's how we teach. We teach with stories, we teach with analogies, because that's how the brain remembers information. And if you can introduce a concept like that, that's more likely to stay in the head than if you teach it in an abstract way. Executive function skills can be taught.
And I have joined this professional development course, and I'm just thrilled with the way it's being conducted. The speakers, all of them so far, have been really awesome. And there are many things which we take away, and the attention grabbers that Gateway is using and is equipping us to use is something which is, it's really beautiful. I mean, class control, class management is something which is, it's working so well. I'm linking the whole thing, taking it back to a classroom. It's just wonderful. I'm extremely happy that I have joined.
Also, taking the positive group redirection, I feel it gives a lot of respect to the student who's actually not following it rather than criticizing him in public. I really love it. I mean, it gives me also a sense of gratification that I have not hurt consciously or subconsciously any child in my class.
Students decided what are the sources they can use to find information or answers to these questions. The electricity consumption at school is increasing every year. Experts from solar panel manufacturing and selling companies came and explained the proposal to them about what it would mean installing solar panels in school.
The inquiry process, that workshop really touched my heart, not only in the terms of how things could be executed beautifully in the class, but the students, I'm actually getting goosebumps right now, the students so beautifully and with such intensity, they have researched, they have actually come to formulating a problem which is so relevant to their everyday life in the school pertaining to conservation of energy, and they have summarized the entire experience and the message that they wanted to convey with the help of that beautiful song. I will not be able to forget that. I think this afternoon was the most beautiful session I've experienced.
Today's session is about vocabulary. Now, all of us as teachers in the classroom know the power of that. Research is catching up. So, I mean, as a teacher, you ask me and say, yeah, of course, I know vocabulary is important. And suddenly, research is saying, yeah, it's super important also. So, there's a lot of research going into how do we teach vocabulary and what is it? And recognizing that vocabulary is so critical for comprehension, so critical for learning. This is a framework that looks at the different words, the vocabulary words, to as a guide to say what to teach. Alright, now tier 1, tier 2, and tier 3. The focus you will have is on the tier 2, that high frequency, high utility.
I'm just waiting for the next session. I am loving it, as they say.